What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to M for Movies. I'm going to start to do more movie reviews. I want to start up early so in 2022 I can start to get into a routine. Just let you know my thoughts on newer movies that are released and whatnot on all the different platforms and what. So today's going to be a new Christmas movie that has just been released on HBO Max this week, and it is 8-Bit Christmas, directed by Michael Dose. Michael Dose has done Take Me Home Tonight, which is also an 80s movie, and this is kind of an 80s movie also. Goon, What If, and Stuber, and then Coffee and Cream, but that wasn't a very good movie. But he's a pretty good action comedy type of director, and this was written by Kevin Jokubowski, who also wrote the novel. So it stars Winslow Feigley, who is a young up and coming actor. Of course, Neil Patrick Harris from How I Met Your Mother and Doogie Howser, Starship Troopers, and Steve Zahn. It was really great to see Steve Zahn in this movie. So he doesn't get too many major roles anymore. So I think he played a great dad to young Jake Duell. And then June Diane Raphael played the mother. Well, this is all about is Neil Patrick Harris is actually playing Jake Duell as the adult version, and set in present day. He shows up at his childhood home, waiting for his parents to come in with his daughter, and they decide to waste some time when they're waiting. He decides to go up to his childhood room, where his old original Nintendo system is, and then they sit down to play it, and then he basically explains, says the story about how, he pretty much got Nintendo. It flashes back to mid-80s to late 80s, and then it's just all about whole story about the coming across Nintendo and how big Nintendo was in the late 80s and whatnot. How was the story, the story and the plot? You've all kind of seen it before. This is very reminiscent to like a Christmas Story, and instead of a Red Ryder BB gun, it is it's a Nintendo. Sort of like the Goldbergs, because it's very 80s. We're in kind of like a mix of very 80s, in the past few years. And if you haven't noticed, I mean, obviously we are. There's a lot of events of what is going around on in Chicago. Chicago Bears football and stuff like that. The family is very much like A Christmas Story. You have the dad who's very hands-on, and he likes to do odd jobs around the house, and he's always messing around with tools and whatnot. There's actually a younger sister who is basically would be the replacement of Ralphie's younger brother, and then you have a whole school full of a mixture of kids and friends. There is even a bully, quite a lot of other stuff like Cub Scouting going on and all that. So it's very nostalgic that if you were raised in your childhood and you wanted the Nintendo system and you're in Cub Scouts and you went around and you sold popcorn. In this movie, they sold Christmas wreaths instead of like popcorn. So we all We all know about that. The setting is very Christmassy with snow. It's almost consistently snowing outside. Even though this is set in Chicago, the majority of the filming was in Toronto. I think the acting was pretty good. Neil Patrick Harris does the narration part, especially for the 80s. So it's very reminiscent of Daniel Stern back in the Wonder Years, and also Christmas Story and the narration of that. I think the family all did a pretty good job. The music was it was good enough for that type of music back in the 80s. It there wasn't a lot of Christmas tunes or anything like that. And then all the nostalgic wanting a Nintendo, wanting a specific toy was there. It was definitely there. All in all, with my feeling on this movie is that I think it kind of copycats what's going on, especially, like I said, I'm consistently pointing out the similarities with A Christmas Story, with 8-Bit Christmas. My rating is about 3 out of 5. It's a good enough watch. It's only about an hour and a half, and so it's well worth checking out, especially with your family this holiday season. It's a very safe, holiday movie. You shouldn't have any problems with the family watching it. All right, everybody, that's it for my review of 8-Bit Christmas, now playing on HBO Max. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, like this review just for the heck of it. Comment down below what you think of 8-Bit Christmas, and am I a little off in saying that it was very similar to A Christmas Story? Yeah, I'm looking forward to doing more reviews. We'll see how this into some consistency on some reviews. So, all right. Take care, everybody, and bye-bye.